Hey guys, Ninetales Commander here, and welcome to episode 44 of Pokemon Battle Zone. So, I'm going to lead off with my physical Thunderous, they're going to lead off with a Garchomp. So, let's get started. I'm going to go ahead and use Knock Off to get rid of whatever hold item they've got, and as it turns out, I don't think it matters, because they've just got a Focus Sash, so it didn't really matter that I discarded his item. So, I'm going to go and get hit by a Rock Slide. I'm pretty sure this is going to knock me out. Wait, does it? No, it doesn't. Wow, I'm genuinely surprised at that, because Rock Slide from a Garchomp is quite powerful, so considering I'm weak to that move, I'm actually surprised I did not die to that. But he's going to bring in his Landorus, and that's going to take, like, very little damage from my superpower. So at this point, it doesn't really matter anyway, because I'm just going to go ahead and get KO'd by my own Life Orb anyway. So I bring in my trustworthy Excadrill now, because I'm Choice Scarfed, and I can go straight in for an Iron Head. I'm really hoping this is going to KO, but it doesn't. But fortunately for me, I do get the Flinch Hacks, which is super nice for me. So now I can just get another turn in. But he's going to go back into his Garchomp now, and I'm going to take an Iron Head, and he's going to do quite a lot of damage. But it doesn't really matter that he doesn't KO, because I'm Choice Scarfed, and I can just go straight in for another Iron Head and get rid of this thing once and for all. So there goes Garchomp, and now he's going to bring in his ex Pokemon, which is Conkeldurr. Now I really don't want to stay in here, because Iron Head is not going to do much to this Pokemon, so I'm going to bring in my Charizard. I think this is my Mega Charizard Y, because I do like Mega Charizard Y more than the other variant, and he's going to go for the Drain Punch, which is going to do very little damage. I'm going to Mega Evolve straight into Mega Charizard Y, and of course with Charizard Y comes the Drought, which is of course great for us. And now I'm just going to go ahead and use Overheat, because I don't want to take any chances with Conkeldurr. It does have a high base HP, so I didn't want to take any chances with it. And did it just live? I don't believe it. I was sure that would KO with the Draught boost, as well as Charizard's amazing special attack when it's in its Y Mega form. So I'm legitimately surprised that it was able to live that. But fortunately, he just goes for another Drain Punch anyway, so it doesn't really matter anyway, to be honest. So, there goes Conkeldurr, and I'm pretty sure whatever comes in next, I'm going to end up switching out from, because there's no way I'm going to do much damage with a minus 4 in my special attack, and I really want to save this thing for later, since I know it will prove helpful. So I bring in my Excadrill now, and he goes for Rock Slide, which is going to do very little damage because I'm 4 times resistant to that move. And in fact, I don't think I even need my Charizard Y at this point, because I believe Landorus is his last Pokemon. So yeah, it actually is. So that's pretty good. So yay, go Excadrill. I really am enjoying using this team. It's actually been pretty helpful so far. So the next opponent's going to lead off with a Ferrothorn, and I've got my Raichu. Ah, this is another team I created a while back, and it actually has a Raichu on it. Yeah, I really like Raichu. It's pretty sweet, if I say so myself. And I'm going to go straight in for a Focus Blast, and that's going to barely not KO anything closer, and it would have won it KO'd. But he goes for the Leech Seed, which, was that really the best choice? I mean, I'm just going to go for another move next turn and KO you anyway, but I guess it's cool to have that extra bit of HP recovery. But there goes Hidden Power, since I think I've got Hidden Power Ice with my Raichu. So at this point, I thought, well, no point risking Focus Blast. I might as well just go ahead and use Hidden Power Ice. So I'm going to go for Thunderbolt. I'm pretty sure this won't KO that Volcarona. In fact, it's not going to do that much damage in the long run. And he's going to go for Quiver Dance now, which is actually a problem for me, because with Quiver Dance, that's going to make his speed and special attack stronger, and it's also going to reduce my damage from Thunderbolt because of the special defense boost that comes along with it. Really, Quiver Dance is a scary move. It's a pretty scary move in the wrong situation. So, probably one of the reasons why Volcarona is so good. So I'm going to switch out, because I know I can't do much damage to this thing with my Raichu. I go into my Infernape, and oh, he's going to go for another Quiver Dance. And I'm still in kind of a bit of trouble here, because he's obviously going to use something to kill me next turn. and I've got my Stone Edge, but I really don't think I'm going to get the chance to use it. So for the next turn, oh, why did you do that? Why didn't you just go for an attacking move? Anything like Psychic would have easily have KO'd me. So, yay, I connect with Stone Edge and that's going to get rid of that thing. That was really a bad play on my opponent's part. He'd have been much better off going straight in for the attack. So I've no idea why he just wasted all those Quiver Dance boosts. Kind of a shame, really. So he brings in Sylveon. I don't want to stay in because I know Stone Edge won't do much to that thing. And he goes for Hyper Voice. I pretty much sent my Raichu in as Death Fodder because my Mega Pokemon on this team is actually Mega Beedrill. But I didn't want to Death Fodder my Beedrill because, well, I'm pretty sure it ain't going to take a Hyper Voice from a Sylveon despite resisting it. So I just Death Foddered my Raichu instead. So now I'm going to Mega Evolve straight into my Mega Beedrill and use Protect on the first turn because, if you guys don't know, regular Beedrill is actually pretty slow and it has to pretty much use Protect on the first turn because otherwise it's going to die rather quickly. Unless of course your opponent's Pokemon is also slow and I didn't want to risk it because I didn't know how fast Sylveon was. But despite that, I'm still able to KO with Poison Jab because Sylveon is not going to take a Poison Jab from a freaking Mega Beedrill. And Mega Beedrill is one of my favourite Pokemon of the current Pokemon games, so that's pretty nice. So, as always, I thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.